What's up, Taiwan? I'm Ethan Liu with news from here in Taiwan and around the world. Transnational organized crime is growing faster than ever across Southeast Asia, and it's become such a big problem that law enforcement agencies cannot keep up. According to a new UN report, crime groups are using online scams to make billions of dollars. The report says that in 2023 alone, between $18 and $37 billion were scammed out of victims across both East Asia and Southeast Asia. Cyber fraud has grown so big that it has taken on industrial-sized proportions, with criminal groups often operating under the guise of industrial and science and technology park, as well as casinos and hotels. The groups are also incredibly sophisticated, using new technologies like generative AI. Deepfake-related crimes are also skyrocketing. To learn more about the huge cyber-enabled fraud groups, Alec McDonald spoke to Joshua James, the regional counter-cybercrime coordinator for the United Nations.
How do these criminal groups operate at such a significant scale that they're able to steal 18 to 30 billion US dollars in South and East Asia alone last year?
These groups are using technologies that have been built to allow normal business to scale massively. Now, on the back of that advancement in technology and the ability to reach audiences around the world that, for example, social media loves, these criminal groups also had the backing of established like money laundering channels and a long history of already being able to channel and flow a lot of money across borders, basically through things like drugs trade. They've done a lot, like we mentioned, with casinos. So that infrastructure was already in place to be able to move massive amounts of money via traditional kind of organized crime groups.
So one of the factors in this is the people that are operating the scams. Your report suggests that many of these people are actually human trafficked and being illegally detained. Can you speak to the scale of the human trafficking going on here? And also, where do these victims come from?
Let's just say that the problem is massive, and specifically because, again, of economic opportunities and people looking for jobs especially. So getting online, looking for a job that sounds too good to be true, and then eventually you go across borders, and that's kind of how the trafficking begins, is looking for legitimate job opportunities. In terms of who is, let's say, most commonly trafficked, it really depends on the scam centers. It depends on the organized groups behind it. It depends on who they're targeting.
The report discusses how these fraud operations, these cyber-enabled fraud operations, are becoming so advanced that law enforcement is really having a difficult time keeping pace with them. Can you discuss a little bit about what law enforcement and NGOs can do to catch up to these fraud groups?
So criminal justice process still fits in that. We have to be much more agile and quick about how that process works. So there's some steps we can take there, just speeding up the way that criminal justice works in every country. NGOs fit in the picture by basically filling the gaps and helping identify, for example, what's happening online, because law enforcement, if they're doing investigations, that's after the event has already happened. NGOs' role would be pre-incident to try a lot more on the prevention side, I would say. But really, if we want to address this, I mean, it's a global problem. Criminal groups, transnational organized crime groups, are not thinking about countries. They're not thinking about borders. So we have to readjust the way that we think about international cooperation.
That was Joshua James, the United Nations Regional Counter-Cybercrime Coordinator. An intricate tunnel network underneath Tokyo keeps the city above water, but increasing levels of rainfall due to climate change threaten to inundate the system. Harrell Hughes reports.
Deep beneath the streets of Tokyo sits this cavernous cathedral. It has 59 pillars, each weighing 500 tons and stretching 18 meters tall, creating a chamber large enough to hold nearly 100 Olympic-sized pools of water. It's part of an intricate system of dams, levees, and tunnels, protecting the city of 37 million people from floods by redirecting floodwaters out of the city. But Tokyo is seeing more downpours than ever before, and its flood prevention system may no longer be enough.
今温暖化の長期的な傾向が続いていますので、これからも気温が上がってさらに強い雨がこれから降ると、今まで降らなかったような記録的な雨が降るということが想定されます。
City officials have decided on a major upgrade, adding a 4.5 kilometer tunnel to the existing system, nearly doubling its size. It's a network that has been in use for the past 23 years, moving floodwaters an average 7 times each year.
被害額として、参考に言いますと、おおむねですね、日本円で1500億円以上の軽減対策はしているかというところになります。
This year, Tokyo's flood system kicked in 4 times in June alone, more than all of 2023. And as Typhoon Chanchan hit Japan in August, the tunnels redirected enough water to fill the Tokyo Dome Stadium almost 4 times over.
ますますこれから気候変動に伴いまして、そういった雨が頻発化するとともにさらに大きな被害が出ると考えられております。そのため我々としてはこういった治水施設を整備することを強化して都民の安全安心を確保していくといったことを考えております。
With unprecedented levels of rainfall hitting Tokyo, the city's flood system has to keep up to keep rainwaters out of people's homesand flowing safely away. Hank Hsu and Harrell Hughes for Taiwan Plus.
A small family-owned farm in California has been growing Taiwanese fruit and vegetables in a suburban backyard for over 20 years. It's become a pillar of the local community, providing a small taste of home over 10,000 kilometers away from Taiwan. Wesley Lewis reports.
Couple Liao Dasheng and Du Fuzhen emigrated from Taiwan to Southern California over two decades ago.They've put down roots there, creating a new home and a small farm.
He said, "I want to grow vegetables." Because there's a large space, so it's like this, slowly growing.
They say they learned most of what they know about agriculture from career farmers back in Taiwan.
Every time I come to Taiwan, I always go to the farmers' market, or the experts in agriculture, or some special vegetable farms.他们都有产销班，请教他们。台湾的天气跟这边天气差别很大，你必须要去摸索它，如何让它在这边吃的味道、口感都跟台湾一样。
The couple grow over 10 different kinds of organic fruit and vegetables, all of which are commonly found in Taiwan, but are hard to come by in the U.S.
台湾的口感，这边我们这边的乡亲绝对会非常喜欢，非常接受。那尤其是莲雾，莲雾在这边，说职业场的莲雾在这边目前还没有。
Over the years, they have slowly introduced more new additions to their crops, including dragon fruit. Their produce has already garnered a loyal customer base.
我的女儿因为在美国生的，可是回到台湾之后吃到莲雾就好喜欢，所以后来发现这边有卖莲雾，我们就特别订了莲雾来这边买。
For now.Liao and Du don't plan on expanding their farm. They say they're satisfied with their backyard business, bringing a small piece of Taiwan to their local community in California. Joseph Wu and Wesley Lewis for Taiwan Plus.
Yunlin County's Beigang Chaotian Temple is setting up a conservation center to care for its collection of over 15,000 historic religious objects.A local university is working with the temple to invest around $31,000 over the next 4 years into restoring the temple's collection and training conservators. Beigang Chaotian Temple is the center of worship for the sea goddess Mazu and welcomes over 8 million visitors each year. The first item slated for restoration is a book from 1767 documenting the goddess' history.Thank you for watching What's Up Taiwan. Finally, take a look at the Women in Art Fair in London, an initiative aimed at promoting gender equality in the industry. I'm Ethan Liu. Take care, and I'll see you next time.